So, for those who may be experiencing workplace sabotaging with your coworkers who may be finding you as defeating them with your work ethics. What that means is that you are showing them out. You are showing them up on your work ethics. You're making them feel like they're nothing or they're weak with their performance. Now, see, this is because of what the culture of the workplace has become. When the culture of the workplace has divided employees to look at themselves as better than the others, the mental capacity of being at this type of workplace will set that type of vibe off. It's all about the culture. That's all. So the higher ups has a lot to do with this shenanigan nonsense. It's not just an individual alone. These people have been developed and have been muppet to act like this at the workplace. And if they don't be part of this act at the workplace, they're going to be singled out and they're going to be picked on. Whether you old, whether you're young, it doesn't matter. It's all about the culture of the workplace. Why? Because what's happening is whatever boss is at the workplace, whatever boss is running the place, it starts at the top. Now, whatever type of boss is running the store or the company, that person has low self-esteem. They have low self-esteem, so they are the matriarch or the patriarch of the family at the workplace. And so they start a trend of this shenanigan by having reward ceremonies and having gift bags to certain people or having meetings and pointing out their favorite workers or whatever, and trying to make others feel low or feel worthless at the workplace, always complaining about their work performance to try to make them feel some type of way so they can what? Quit. You know what I'm saying? And then for some cases, if they can't, if they're not willing to quit, what they do, they try other strategies by provoking them to get fired. And provoking an employee into getting fired could be anything. Being angry, cussing out, lashing out, fighting, stealing, or whatever. It's all about what Satan is muppeting those who are willing to be henchmen of Satan. And yes, I'm talking about the workplace. If you are experiencing being bullied or sabotaged at the workplace, do not quit. Real talk, do not quit. And do not be easily sent into provocation where you may get fired. What you need to do is be like Jesus, and that's continuously enduring, enduring, enduring. When Jesus was before he was flogged, he was weighed by the crowd on who should be set free between him or Barabbas. Now, come on now. It's obvious to the eye that Barabbas should not have been set free. He was a murderer. He killed one of theirs. And he was set free. Because the higher ups, which who were the Barabbas, the Pharisees and the Sadducees, they did not like Jesus because he was of truth. People take being like Jesus is weak. How dare we? No, that's where the strength was at. See, God Almighty had all of this plan for an example for mankind. He had that plan as an example for mankind on how we should be, because we are going to go through the storms, period. We are not going to avoid it. What gives us the strength is dependent on God, relying on God to bless us to go through the storm. We can't go through it on our own mentally. We have to go through it with God's strength. That's the number one strength that we're going to have. Now, God is going to test us to see if we're going to give up or give in. He can't use us no more if we're willing to give in. That's the part where we can't give up our crown. Satan is out here to take our crown, because Satan know that we're going to be the ones who's going to put him away, and the demons. So Satan is working overtime to get us not to be able to do that. Huh? But see, prophecy is the number one ingredient for our strength. It's going to happen anyway. But do you want to be part of that? See, do you want to be that one who's going to put Satan away? I know I do. So I have to endure being around people who are willing to treat me bad. See, and it looks like they're getting away with it. But God laughs at the wicked, for he knows their day is coming. Huh? He see their day is coming. Huh? So we have to endure. We have to endure. They're not getting away with it. And see, that's what make it even worse for them. Because the more and the longer they live their life like this, the harder they're going to have to pay the price. The harder the punishment is going to come upon them. See? And only with our eyes, hallelujah, the called out ones, those who they're nitpicking with, only with our eyes shall we see the reward of the wicked. Oh, let me tell you something. As we're going through the storms and we're doing our job and we're doing it right, and they keep laughing and they plotting and scheming, and the higher ups is playing these games and trying to manipulate us and provoke us to quit and get fired and all that, trust me, deep down inside they're crying. They're hurt, they're bothered, because they are afraid of our presence. People could like my presence and your presence if you're a beast, just to help them succeed with clearance of the work ethics. See, people only like us to a degree if it's going to benefit them. But if we're doing things that may not personally benefit them, they're going to dislike us. Huh? So you have to be careful, have a sound mind, and have self-awareness. Be alert and know that if somebody is doing things, sabotaging and complaining and nitpicking and nagging and doing things and whispering and laughing out loud and ignoring you and playing these little games as you outside sitting in your car, you got others that's parking their cars looking at you and staring at you, rolling all up on you and all these games. All this is by Satan. It's allowed by God through Satan to them as henchmen to send you into provocation so you can lose your crown. That's it. And as you're going through this, on the inside, you're upset and you really want to take control of the situation and act. See, deep down inside, on the inside, they're but they're bothered by your presence. Deep down inside, we're not showing no emotions. We're constantly just trying to get by and do our thing in the sight of God by living in righteousness. But deep down inside, we really want to react. Let me tell you that, I'm not lying. We really want to kill. We really want to hurt. We really want to do everything to get our lick back right then and there, which is a physical thing. And we can't do that. And they deep down inside may want to hurt us too, because they jealous or because they envy us. Or they want the things that we have and they can't get it. So let me tell you something. It's both ways. But the awesome thing about us going through what we're going through, we're going through it for the Lord. They're doing what they're doing for Satan. See? And see, there's a prize for both. Ours is a heavenly reward awaiting for us. All eternal. It's an eternal blessing waiting for us. And with them, they're going to have eternal destruction. They're going to die. And they're going to be forgotten. And before they die, they're going to suffer through the great tribulation if they don't repent. And see, not only do they have to repent, but they must apologize to everybody who they purposely done wrong. So having a sound mind and being having self-awareness at the workplace when people are trying to send you to provocation is very important, people. Do not give up and do not allow someone to take your crown by sending you into provocation, to lose your job, to go to jail. That's too easy. You're living your life on the run all the time because you killed somebody. who just irritated you to the bone, who been irritating you for years, and you just decided to just take matters in your own hand. No, the longer we endure, the better we become, the better of a position we get into the kingdom. When we become part of the first resurrections, we're going to have positions. And what we endure here on earth, with all greater endurance, we're going to get greater rewards. I'm trying to tell you something. Huh? The little bit that we endure, that's how small the reward we're going to get. We're going to get the reward, but it's going to be a small reward. Then you get medium rewards. Then you get big rewards. Huh? So when you're going to the kingdom, you want to have a reward is a reward. I ain't going to lie to you. But you don't want to be like, nah, you know, I get whatever I get. No, you want to get great rewards. You want to be part of those who put Satan away. See, we can't put Satan away. We can't put the demons away if we can't endure the henchmen on earth. Huh? See, let me tell you a little something before I close out. Before the first resurrection take part of putting Satan and the demons away, the Antichrist and the beast are going to be destroyed even before Jesus returns. Huh? Revelation 19 tells me so. 1,000 years before us putting Satan away, 1,000 years before this, the beast and the Antichrist will be destroyed for all eternity. Now, how's that going to happen? Who are going to destroy that? Who are going to destroy these two mortal men? Huh? And this, like I said, is before Yeshua HaMashiach come back. So we got some things we have to prepare for. We have to prepare for war, spiritual warfare, to put these evil beings away for all eternity. Stay strong, keep a sound mind, stay prayed up, and beat these people who think they are winning you. Shalom.